got the idea that somebody else's body is beautiful. As long as you have the idea some other body is beautiful, you will continue to struggle and struggle and struggle and struggle and struggle. Even after death, you will worry, what dress they are putting on, going to put on me, I don't know. You will write a will and create life insurance. Anyhow, when you have the idea somebody else's body is beautiful, even after death, you cannot relax. Even after death, you cannot relax. Understand, your body is beautiful. Your body is enough. You are beautiful unto yourself. This is the way God has chiseled you. This is the way God has created you. This is a masterpiece from the master of the universe. You can never be intelligent than the whole. Can you be intelligent than God? Can you be intelligent than the whole? Part can never be intelligent than the whole. Each one decides the way in which they want to live before taking birth. And based on that, the body is created. If you live your whole life just by eating, 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 doing nothing except eating such big Coca-Cola bottle, such big Starbucks coffee, and such big
McDonald's.
No, not only McDonald's.
Chips.
What about chips? And burgers, building like a story, multi-story burgers. And if you continuously eat and spend your whole life just for eating. I always tell you, there are two kinds of people. People who eat to live. People who live to eat. If you spend your whole life just by eating, naturally what you will think? Next Janma, even if I take one more body, what am I going to do? I'm going to eat. Let me take the pig body, I can eat lot. So you choose to take the pig birth. That is the way you decide. See, the way in which you live, based on that you decide your next body. And if you live whole life just sleeping, what do you think? After all, I'm going to sleep. Let me have a better body which can help me to sleep. Buffalo body is the best body. It is based on which the attitude in which you live, based on that you decide. So some people, they do not want to take the responsibility of some parts of the body. So they leave that and come. And one more thing, if you have suffered too much because of your leg pain in past Janma, next time you think, better let me not have that portion at all. And let me give you an incident which happened. It's not a story, it's a history. In America it happened. In one MSP, one of our devotees, in the MSP we talk about the guilt, how the people feel guilty about their life, and we open up our guilts. One lady, actually, she was suffering for 22 years having a tumor in Muladhara. She was having a tumor in the Muladhara. For 22 years she was suffering, even after surgery. Once she underwent surgery, but again it came back. The tumor came. She's suffering. And she did a MSP. Actually, when we were opening up our guilt layer, she started speaking about she being abused sexually when she was a very small girl. When she was a girl, she has been abused sexually by some of her own relatives. And that continued for more than 10 years. That created such deep guilt and energy blockage in her Muladhara. She says, I always hated that portion. I feel in my body, if I can somehow remove that Muladhara area and throw it away, I'll be happy. She hated that portion so much. And she opened up this guilt and she wept like anything. And finally I spoke to her and I said, don't worry. Now you opened up your guilt, it will be healed. When you open in front of the master's energy, guilt simply get flushed away. Because guilt is a low energy. When you open it, it just gets flushed. It is cleansed. It is clear. I said, it is clear now, don't worry. That very opening is enough. You will be surprised. In 11 days, the tumor disappeared. It has disappeared, and already 6 months over, it has never come back. It has not come back. It got healed. It is not there now. 20 years of tumor disappeared. I just gave her one small meditation technique. I told her, don't do anything. Just sit and meditate in that area. And not only that, stop hating that area. You are supposed to hate that person, not yourself. You are supposed to hate only that person, not yourself. Don't hate your body. Sit in the bathtub. Just sit and feel you are inhaling and exhaling through the hip area, through the molar area, so that the awareness can be awakened. The hatred can be removed. The disconnection can be again bridged. The connection can again happen. You will be surprised in 11 days tumor disappears. Understand this incident. This will make you understand hating the body is no way going to help you. I was answering your question. The people who hate some portion of their bodies due to some, like this incident, they come without the part. That is the problem.
So it's kind of like their own doing.
Yes.
Is that they come in that particular state of
own misunderstanding. Not even doing, own misunderstanding. Now let me explain the next step in the concept of somebody else being beautiful. Concept of the beauty. You can't even drink a cup of water using the other body, can you? No. Even if he or she is beautiful, you cannot do anything about it. This is the instrument you have. This instrument is the instrument with which you live. With this only you can eat. With this only you can live. With this only you can enjoy the planet Earth. You can enjoy the life. So why do you bother so much about somebody else's body? There's a beautiful book written by one doctor, Louis L. Hay. You can heal yourself. Any of you have read that book?
Yes.
I feel she is a lady who attained the Satori. She is a lady. At least one Satori she must have had. Because I can never expect a doctor who has never read anything of Eastern religion so clear in her ideologies. She herself underwent cancer. She had cancer when she was young, and she overcame the cancer, and she healed herself. And not only she got healed herself, and the techniques which she used, she has brought it out, and she is helping thousands of people to heal her. Heal also with the techniques. And not only that, she has done a deep research, scientific research, and proved everything. Whatever Patanjali and Tantra says, the major concepts, she has done everything by research, by working with a group of disciples or a group of patients, by observing the report, reading, everything. She has presented so beautifully. How many of you have read that book? You can heal yourself. Wonderful lady. I felt that she's a lady, at least if she would have been in India, she would have been respected as a saint. But at least this I can say, every bit, I read page by page, every bit is our wisdom of the masters, ancient masters. But one thing she brought in a modern term, in a beautiful way she presented. You can go through. Anyhow, in that she says, the moment you start thinking somebody else's body is beautiful, you implant the seed of cancer inside you. You sow the seed of cancer inside you. Because you stop living inside your body totally. You start living like a ghost. It is true. I tell you from my own personal experience. Let me tell you one of my fantasy. Before enlightenment, I always had a fantasy about Vivekananda. I should look like Vivekananda. I should talk like Vivekananda. I should dress like Vivekananda and all those things before enlightenment. And after enlightenment, when I was scanning my old mental setup and all those things, the day I started thinking that I should become like Vivekananda, I should think like Vivekananda, the uneasiness which started in my body was there till I became enlightened. Only when I became enlightened, the craze stopped and I became Vivekananda. Only when the idea that I should look like Vivekananda dropped, I became Vivekananda. I tell you, it's my personal experience. I do not know how much you will be able to understand. In my mind, I could analyze and find out. Forget about this. What you said?
Marilyn Monroe,
all these names. Even Vivekananda. If you think that you should become like somebody, you should look like somebody, then you are in trouble. Look as you are. Be as you are. Your body is beautiful unto itself. Appreciate your body. Learn to appreciate yourself. I think this meditation ladies can do easily. You can stand always in front of mirror very easily. Yes.
What is there a negative thing that happens, like if you look at, if it would be the opposite of what you just said, if you look at a body that is like something you don't want to be, like if somebody was obese and you look at them and say, oh,
you are going to create a problem. Even when you are creating a fear, you are creating an imprint inside you. There is no need to be afraid. See, the fear and greed, both are standing topsy-turvy, that's all. Fear, when it stands topsy-turvy, it's a greed. The greed, when it stands topsy-turvy, fear. Fear and greed are one and the same. Maybe two sides of same kind. So, the same way, if you have a greed or you have fear, you are in trouble. You are in trouble. I think mostly we have only greed. Fear is very less. But, according to me at least, mostly only greed we have. Usually we have only greed. And even I should not look like that means you should look like something. That something is a greed. So root is the greed. First thing, drop. And next thing, once in a while, stand in front of mirror and appreciate your body. Appreciate your body. Do you see the kids? How they are alive? You see the kids? They are the alive or the life which is there in the cheek. The same life will be there in the feet also. The shining, the alive, the life in the cheek and the feet will be same. You can't differentiate. But look at your body. The life in the cheek and life in the leg. Because you don't live in your whole body. You don't live in your whole body. Kids are alive in their cheeks and feet. You are dead in both. That is the problem. They are alive. They are just living, bubbling, because they don't have idea that they should look like somebody. They are supposed to become like somebody. The moment the idea enters, you should become like somebody, you should look like somebody, a deep tension starts happening inside you. And I tell you from my personal experience, I know many supermodels, many so-called, at least in India, not America, in India, many so-called supermodels or many models, actors, very closely, they also suffer the same trouble. You crave seeing them, they are craving seeing somebody else. Be very clear, you crave seeing them and they crave seeing somebody else. And just before coming to States, one very famous guy, he's an actor and supermodel. He came to the ashram to give farewell. He was telling me, so Swamiji, you are seeing our DVD wrappers and you are sitting and talking with me. Swamiji, even we don't allow to take such close-up shots. If you come to the field of acting, we all have to leave the field and we should become a Swami. I told him, are you a fool? My main teaching itself, don't look at the other body. And you are coming and looking at me and coming to passing this comment. I am teaching you, and the, before I finish my teaching, he works against the teaching on me. I told him, surely don't be afraid, I won't come to your field. That is different. And second thing, don't be, people are crazy of your farm, you are crazy of some other farm. That is not going to work. Craving or seeing, thinking somebody else is beautiful will make you as a split personality. Will not let your intelligence, bio-intelligence, be totally alive. You will not appreciate, enjoy your whole body totally. A simple meditation technique to do two work. First work is to cleanse the energy blockages. Throughout your body there are so many energy blockages. Like a blood clot, there is a thing called energy clot. The energy blockages. If you can remove these energy clots, energy blockages, naturally your inborn healing tendency will be awakened. You will have your healing, the innate healing habit will be awakened. The quality of self-healing, the power to heal yourself will increase. That's the first step. Second step, awakening the intelligence, part by part, how are we going to do?